This is the fourth video in an introductory series to Unidata's Integrated Data Viewer. Previous episodes have covered the layout of the interface. This episode will explain how to create data displays and subset gridded data. We'll go over how to choose data from some sources that haven't been talked about yet, how to subset the data, and how to use time drivers. We need two data sets for this demonstration, ideally with different time resolutions. The HER would be good for one of these. And let's take the NAM for the other. Now that we have our datasets, we can use them to create displays. Both datasets should have temperature at ground level, so let's plot that. We'll make a color-shaded plot from the NAM data with all of the default settings. We'll go over what these are later in the video, but for now they're fine. And we'll go through the same process with the HER data, but we'll only draw the contour lines instead of filling the contours so that we can see both datasets at the same time. We still need to change one of the color bars so that we can see both datasets. And theoretically, we have everything that we need to create an animation. But the times aren't aligned. Some frames have data from both sets, others have one, and the HER data display changes faster than the NAM display. We can fix this with a time driver. We could create a time driver and impose it on the displays we already have, but it's much more efficient to create the time driver before the displays. This keeps the computer from processing frames that won't be used. The start and end time should be set to times when both data sources have data. The HER limits the time range because the model doesn't run as far into the future. The resolution should typically be that of the dataset with the lower time resolution. Since the HER has data at every time step that the NAM does, the easiest way to select all of the times when both data sources have data is to use selected on the NAM data and select all of the times up to the end of the HER's availability. Make sure that use's time driver is selected before creating the NAM display. To select times for the HER, we just select Match Time Driver. Now the animation only includes data specified by the time driver. While less data is shown, the reduced distractions make it easier to understand. Now you know everything that you need to make your own bundles from scratch and use the IDV for most basic applications. It does take some time to get used to, but it's well worth taking the time to learn how to use. The rest of the episodes in this series will focus on more advanced topics and worked examples. There's no reason to watch them in any particular order. Just see what looks interesting and have fun exploring. If you run into any problems, visit our website at unidata.ucar.edu or email support-idv@ucar.edu.